Welcome to the refresher course organized by APA College of Arts and Culture, Palani. It is my great honor to be present here on the biophysics. I am thankful to the organizers of APA College, the management of APA College, and especially thanks to Professor Kokileshwar Madam. Today I am going to present my topic on biophysics. Let us see what exactly it means, since this refresher course is organized for the physics and chemistry in particular, but in general the biology too, because the life is because of the physics and chemistry. If all these three elements come together, then and then only the life sustains. Yes. What you observe in the title might be a number of participants looking towards title and say, oh, what is this? I am intentionally typed like this because it is very habitual to us that the first letter is always capital and the rest of the other small letters. And this is nothing but the way of presentation of physics, that is the use of light and the vision, which emphasize the use of physics in the world of biology. So let us see what exactly this biophysics covers. Well-known Khalil Gibran quote that the eye of a human being is a microscope which makes the world seem bigger than it really is. Very true. Today we all know that we all are engaged in the online education, e-learning system, webinars, workshop, conferences, and much more things. One of the invitation of this present refresher course is again through the media, and this media is nothing but
on
again
of APA College
by
of
our eyes.
Arts and Culture, PG and Research Department of Chemistry,
so
and Physics
to
going
this,
to conduct an online refresher course
slides,
for science academics
light,
in Moodle platform from
colors,
24th June to 7th July. Resource persons
sound,
from overseas,
yes, course,
and all over India, all are cordially invited
in
to register and get enriched. Thank you.
Physics, that is the sound waves. So both the light waves and the sound waves are very vital in the biology. So objective of today's presentation is, first of all, we see the history, then we see what exactly the biophysics means and the classification of this, and later on we will talk on the some aspects of the physics with relation to the biology and how this biology is fulfilled with the help of physics and the chemistry. Ours is not a new subject, but over its long history, biophysics or biological physics has come to mean many different things to different communities. At the same time, for many physicists today, biophysics remains new and perhaps a bit foreign. There is an excitement to working in a new field, and I hope to capture this excitement. Where is the boundary between physics and biology? Yes, is biophysics really physics or just the application of methods from physics to the problems of biology? My biologist friends tell me that theoretical biology is nonsense. So what would theoretical physicists be doing if they got interested in this field. Advanced interdisciplinary science involving physics, biology, chemistry, mathematics. In 1892, Carl Pearson's work on the biophysics, and he named the biophysics missing link between biology and the physics in the grammar of science. In 1943, the lecture series on what is life, told by the Erwin Schrödinger, who got Nobel Prize in 1933. In 1946, Biophysics Research Unit in the King's College, London, hire physicists to work on questions of biological significance, that is X-ray diffraction of DNA. We know the Rosalind Franklin. In 1953, Francis Crick, the particle physicist turned into biophysicist at Cambridge, and James Watson, a well-known biologist. This is because of they know because of the double helix structure of DNA. And in 1957, the Biophysical Society founded. So next is, what is biophysics? Biophysics, yes, it is an amalgamation of biology and the physics. Let us say biophysics is a bridge between biology and physics. A number of scientists, researchers, writers write different definitions of this, but in a lucid language we say it is a bridge between biology and the physics. Biophysics is the study of biological systems and biological processes using physics-based methods or based on physical principles. Very precisely what we say is, biophysics is an interdisciplinary science that explains the laws and principles of physics which govern various biological processes. Biophysics span all levels of biological organization, from molecular scale to whole organism. Biophysics is that branch of knowledge that applies the principles of physics and chemistry and the methods of mathematical analysis too, and computer modeling, to understand how biological systems work. Now we move on to the classification. Biophysics can be classified depending on the relative size of biological subject. Say, for example, molecules, or cells, or tissues, or the whole organism. Might be some organs too, or which techniques and application is employed. So biophysical subjects based on relative size of subject. First of all, the molecular and subcellular biophysics. Second one is physiological and anatomical biophysics. Third one is environmental biophysics. The techniques, yes, biophysical techniques and applications are general five biophysical techniques, imaging biophysics, medical biophysics. Let us see one by one. Molecular and subcellular biophysics. Most common branches of biophysics deals with molecules and subcellular functions. This division of biophysics is sometimes also called biochemical physics, physical biochemistry, or biophysical chemistry. All three terms mean the same thing. What we will call molecular and subcellular biophysics. It is the place where biology, chemistry, and physics all meet together and work for the entire humanity. How they perform? The structure and conformation of biological molecules, structure function relationship, conformational transitions, ligand binding and intermolecular binding, diffusion and molecular transport. Again, they work on the membrane biophysics, DNA and nucleic acid, energy flow and bioenergetics, statistical mechanics, kinetics, molecular machines. The next one is physiological and anatomical biophysics. Biomechanics is the branch of biophysics that deals with the application of forces to biological objects. Notice that biomechanics is studied at all levels, subcellular, physiological, and environmental too. The next branch is electrophysiology. Electrophysiology is the study of electrical aspects of living things. Its main focus is the study of nerves. It is concerned with excitable tissue that create, conduct, or use electrical impulses. Excitable tissues include nerves, muscles, sensory cells, and electroreceptive cells. Sensory biophysics, electrophysiology, both are explores and their mechanism of the senses. Seeing, hearing, touch, balance, smell, and taste. All these five senses are studied in the sensory biophysics and electrophysiology. Sensory biophysics explores questions such as how proteins, you know, the involvement of chemistry is here. The proteins in the eye respond to different energies of light. How electrical signals from retina are transmitted to the brain and how the eye muscles move the eye, focus the eye, and adjust the amount of light entering the eye. This is just because of the molecules, that is nothing but the chemistry, chemicals. The next branch is environmental biophysics. Environmental biophysics focuses on the physical aspects of the relationship between the organisms and their environment. The primary source of energy in the environment is solar energy. Nowadays, we are very much eager and interested to work on the solar energy, which is captured through the process of photosynthesis and converted by plants into food. There are other areas of focus within environmental biophysics as well, and these are heat and temperature environmental biophysics, resource and mass exchange environmental biophysics, radiation biophysics, environmental bioengineering, etc. The next one is the biophysical techniques and applications. Ultracentrifugation, yes, it is very, very useful in the field of biochemistry and in the biology too. This is for the separation of biomolecules or the molecules of different sizes based on the sedimentation principle of the physics. Electrophoresis, yes, it is again to separate molecules of different molecular mass or the size based on the sedimentation principle. Another principle is electric field acts on the charged molecules, and the beautiful example is gel electrophoresis. Another one is the spectroscopy. It is mostly and widely used by the biologist and even the all scientists all over the world. Mostly with the electromagnetic radiation and measuring the intensity, direction, polarization of the emitted radiation. In addition to EM, also electrons and mass spectroscopy is used. Originally, it works only the visible spectrum 380 to 750 nanometer. Now, also we use the UV and infrared, ultraviolet and infrared. Mass spectrometry to measure mass or molecular weight of molecules. Molecules are ionized in a vacuum. They pass through a magnetic field and then we detect the mass of the molecule. The very beautiful example of the another technique is X-ray crystallography to determine the relative positions of atoms within a crystal by using diffraction on a 3D crystal lattice. High resolution of structural details, but the molecules need to be in a crystalline phase. The next one is very important as far as the chemistry is concerned is nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy, NMR. This is to obtain structural information about molecules of the highest resolution using EM of a radio frequency which interacts with the nuclear spins of atoms in a large magnetic field. And the last one is electron microscopy. To view objects 1000 to 2500 times smaller than those seen by a light microscope. The next point is how essential is biophysics to progress in biology? It's very interesting this one. Biophysics discovers how atoms are arranged to work in DNA and proteins. Biophysicists are discovering how proteins work. They use this protein structure for discovering how biological machines work in health and also in diseases. As we know that today we are all gone through a huge pandemic disease that is because of the coronavirus COVID-19. And again, we all know that the protein structure of this is very critical, and that is why we are not getting success to control it. This is a part of this biophysicist work. The third one is variations in proteins make people respond to drugs differently. Understanding these differences opens new possibilities in drug design, diagnosis, disease control, and decrease of side effects. The next question is then arises, what are the applications of biophysics? The first is the applications of biophysics depend on society's needs. In the 20th century, great progress was made in treating disease. Biophysics helped create powerful vaccines against infectious diseases. It described and controlled diseases of metabolism such as diabetes. Biophysics provided both the tools and the understanding of treating the diseases of growth known as cancers. Then what are the applications of biophysics? Biophysical methods are increasingly used to serve everyday needs from forensic science to bioremediation. Biophysics gives us medical imaging technologies including MRI, CAT scans, and sonograms for diagnosing diseases. It provides the life-saving treatment methods of kidney dialysis, radiation therapy, cardiac defibrillators, and pacemakers. Then why is biophysics important right now? Biophysics discovers how to modify microorganisms for biofuel. This is for replacing gasoline and diesel fuel. And bioelectricity. This is for replacing petroleum products and coal for producing electricity. Biophysics discovers the biological cycles of heat, light, water, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, heat, and organisms throughout our planet. Biophysics harnesses microorganisms to clean our water and to produce life-saving drugs. Instrumentation and biophysical methods also play a very important role. Measuring systems are used to provide quantitative information about parameters of biological importance. Such parameters may include biopotentials from muscles, neurons, eyes, heart or brain, blood pressure or muscle forces. The signal may take different forms such as being mechanical or electrical. Electrical signals are the most popular and they have to be well treated so as to eliminate unwanted signals and amplified to be displayed. Examples of some electrical signals are electrical potential of nerves, electrical signals from muscles to the electromyogram, from the heart to the electrocardiogram, from the brain the electroencephalogram, signal from the eye the electroretinogram and the electrooculogram. Cardiovascular instrumentation: biopotentials of the heart, electrodes, amplifiers, patient monitoring, defibrillators, pacemakers, etc. Applications of electricity and magnetism in medicine: electrical shock, high frequency electricity in medicine, low frequency electricity and magnetism in medicine, current research involving electricity applied in the body. Sound use in the medicine: general properties of the sound, the body as a drum, which again used for the percussion in the medicine, ultrasound pictures of the body, ultrasound measure motion, physiological effects of ultrasound in therapy, the production of speech, that is phonation. Physics of ear and hearing: as we know, the outer ear, the middle ear and the inner ear. The sensitivity of the ears, testing your hearing, deafness and hearing aids. All these tapes include, yes, the anatomical structure of the body of the ear. But similarly, the sound waves travels through the three bones, that is incus, malleus and stapes, which transfer the waves into the cochlea, and then we hear this sound. With the help of, again, yes, of course, the chemistry, the protein molecule which transfer signal to the brain. The next is light in medicine: measurement of light and its units, applications of visible light in medicine, applications of ultraviolet and infrared light in medicine, laser medicine, application of microscopes in medicine. Physics of eyes and vision: focusing elements of eye, diffraction effects on the eye, defective vision and its correction, color vision and chromatic aberration, instruments used in ophthalmology. Physics of diagnostics, X-ray: production of X-ray beam, how X-ray are absorbed, making an X-ray image, radiation to patient from X-rays, X-ray slices of the body. Again, physics is used in the radiation therapy. The dose units used in radiotherapy are the rad and gray. Principles of radiation therapy: a short course in radiotherapy treatment planning, mega voltage therapy. This is again useful in the case of cancer, as we know well. Heat and cold in medicine: heat and cold are nothing but the properties of temperature. Physics basis of heat and temperature: thermometry and temperature scales, thermography mapping the body's temperature, heat therapy, use of cold in medicine, cryosurgery, etc. Some of the giants of classical physics, the Helmholtz, Maxwell and Rayleigh, to name a few, routinely cross borders among disciplines that we now distinguish as physics, chemistry, biology and even psychology. Some of their forays into the phenomena of life were driven by a desire to test the universality of physical laws, such as the conservation of energy. A very different motivation was that our own view of the world is determined by what we can see and hear, and more subtly by what we can reliably infer from the data that our sense organs collect. These physicists thus were drawn to the study of the senses. For them, there was no boundary between optics and vision, or between acoustics and hearing. Can you identify the number in circle, that is figure in the circle? I will give you some time. Observe very carefully and find out which number is represented in circle. Yes, very good. The number is 5. Might be some are failed to identify the number. This is because of the color blindness. Yes, this color blindness is again a part of physics and chemistry. The red cells and cone cells absorb the light and convert it into the vision with the help of chemicals which is present into the cells. And if the cells lack with the chemicals, we are unable to identify some colors, and that is why we have not identified the figure which is represented in the circle. So most of all, soaring ambition is that physics should not stop at the point where light hits our eyes or sound enters our ears, and that we should search for a physics that reaches all the way to our personal conscious experience of the world in all its beauty. Yes, the beauty in the circle as you observe here. Now we move to the specific involvement of the physics into the biology in relation with the chemistry too. Let us try to know one experiment or one example from the biology is the fly embryo. Is an interesting model system for many reasons. One is that there is a well-developed genetics for fruit flies is established. The Latin name or the scientific name of the fruit flies is Drosophila melanogaster. It made possible not least by their rapid growth and reproduction. A now classic set of genetic experiments showed that the number of genes that are relevant in these early patterning events is small, on the order of 100 out of the roughly 25,000 genes in the whole fly genome. If we focus on the pattern along the anterior-posterior axis of the embryo, the number of relevant genes is less than 20. Most of these genes code for transcription factors that control the expression of other genes. So the resultant figure is like this. The brightness of the fluorescence should indicate the concentration of the protein. And this image is again captured because of the use of chemicals and the physics. Use of chemistry and the physics. How? Let us see. Suppose we stop that action in the embryo at cycle 14, that is the multiplication of the cells, and measure the concentration of two of these key proteins. One way to do this is to make antibodies against the protein we are interested in, and then make antibodies against the antibodies. But before using the secondary antibodies, we attach to them a fluorescent dye molecule, fluorescent dye. So if we expose the embryo first to one antibody, which should stick to the protein we are interested in and not anywhere else. If we are lucky, then we were lucky because the antibodies attach or the bind. And to the other, we should have the effect of attaching fluorescent dyes to the protein we are looking for. And hence, if we look under a microscope, the brightness of the fluorescence should indicate the concentration of the protein. Not obvious if this relationship is quantitative, hold that question. One such experiment is shown in figure 116. It means what I showed you in previously. Evidently, the concentration of the proteins varies with position, and this variation corresponds to stripped pattern, as we see in the case of image. This is a stripped pattern. You see here, In the interaction between physics and biology, what happens to chemistry? Is the question remains. How much biology do I need to know in order to make progress? Why do physicists and biologists seem to be speaking such different languages? Can I be interested in biological problems and still be a physicist, or do I have to become a biologist? Although there has been much progress over the last decade. Yes, we know that, you all know that carbohydrate, proteins, lipid, nucleic acid, minerals, ions, etc., etc., vitamins, all these are the molecules, biomolecules. This is nothing but the part of chemistry. And because of this, all molecules, all chemical molecules, all the chemistry, the life sustain. Biology works, as we see in the previous example of the Drosophila melanogaster. So thank you very much to hear me. Once again, I am thanks to the APA College management, the principal of APA College, Professor Kokileshwar Madam, to give me such wonderful opportunity. Thank you very much.